Good morning, and welcome to Our Lady of Grace. All of our music for this Mass can be found in your Brown Catholic Community hymnal. New Eucharistic ministers for the Mass, homebound, and nursing homes will be commissioned after Mass today in the Day Chapel. Today is Donut Sunday. Please join us in Albany's Hall after Mass for refreshments and fellowship. The food pantry collection will be held next weekend. As we continue our journey through this Lenten season, we would like to invite you to share in this special ministry to serve those less fortunate in our community. All liturgical ministers who do not receive the schedule by email may now pick up a new hard copy of your new schedule on the book rack. In regards to the temperature in the church building, since the weather has been fluctuating from one day to the next to extremely cold temperatures, it is almost impossible to keep a comfortable temperature in such a large space, but particularly the church and the day chapel. So we ask for your patience and understanding while we move through this winter. We know that spring is not too far off. And please be sure to take a bulletin home, as there are many announcements and details. And we ask that you please silence or turn off all cell phones and pagers in preparation for this Mass. Our opening hymn is number 242, Tree of Life. Please stand.
Good morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of you. My sisters, my brothers, we gather here today on this third Sunday of the season of Lent, a time to deepen our awareness of our weakness, of our limitations, to deepen our need for God's wonderful forgiveness. And so as we begin this celebration of His presence with us today, let us take these moments to ask for that gift that God so generously gives to us, His forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to life everlasting.
Amen. Let us pray.
O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting and prayer and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously upon this confession of our lowliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, in their thirst for water, the people grumbled against Moses, saying, "Why did you ever make us leave Egypt? Was it just to have us die here of thirst with our children and our livestock?" So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? A little more and they will stone me." The Lord answered Moses, "Go over there in front of the people, along with some of the elders of Israel, holding in your hand as you go the staff with which you struck the river. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock in Horeb. Strike the rock, and the water will flow from it for the people to drink." This Moses did in the presence of the elders of Israel. The place was called Massah and Meribah, because the Israelites quarreled there and tested the Lord, saying, "Is the Lord in our midst or not?" The word of the Lord.
Be with me, Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope for the glory of God. And hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Now Jesus came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of land that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. And Jacob's well was there. And Jesus, tired from his journey, sat down there at the well. It was about noon. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone into the town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How can you, a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink? For Jews use nothing in common with Samaritans." And Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God, and who is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you do not even have a bucket, and the cistern is deep. Where then can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this cistern and drank from it himself with his children and his flocks?" And Jesus answered and said to her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water that I shall give will never thirst. The water I shall give will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I may not be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water. I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you people say that the place to worship is in Jerusalem." And Jesus said to her, "Believe me, woman, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You people worship what you do not understand, we worship what we understand, because salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, and is now here, when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. And indeed, the Father seeks such people to worship him. God is spirit. Those who worship him must worship in spirit and in truth. The woman said to him, I know that the Messiah is coming, the one called the Christ. And when he comes, he will tell us everything. And Jesus said to her, I am he, the one speaking with you. Now many of the Samaritans of that town began to believe in him. And when the Samaritans came to him, they invited him to stay with them. And he stayed there for 2 days. Many more began to believe in him because of his word. And they said to the woman, we no longer believe because of your word, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world. The Gospel of the Lord. Now, certainly, everyday experience, every hour of the day, unless the most important, certainly basic material element that comes from this earth and is so important in our everyday lives is the element of water, H2O. We know as the those who study the outer space beyond the earth are looking for earthly bodies or universal bodies that might contain life, they're looking for water. So essential. It's true that there are times when we have too much water, and so we have floods. And there are times when we have not enough water. And we have droughts. We cannot live without it. I believe it is a medical fact that we can live without food for several weeks, but only without water for a few days. So how much more so in a very dry desert climate as ancient Palestine, and as it is today, for a matter of fact, no pipes underground to transport water from where it might be gotten, how important and significant water was, as it still is. And this is certainly the key element in our gospel today, on this third Sunday of Lent. Jesus, in all his humanity, was thirsty. Like all of us, we get thirsty. And he was alone at the well. His disciples had gone into the village. He was by himself. And there was the famous well of Jacob there. But Jesus had no way to get anything down. He had no bucket to get down into the well to bring water up. And along comes a Samaritan and a woman. Now, Jews had nothing to do with Samaritans, and certainly a Jewish man would never be seen alone with a woman, let alone a Samaritan woman. And so what happens here is Jesus asks her for a drink of water. Now this means that the utensil that she's going to give water to him with is a utensil that he could be made impure by, because of not only the circumstances of a woman and a Samaritan woman, he's drinking from the same utensil that she would have used herself. Unclean. And so what happens here, there's a relationship begins to develop between Jesus and the woman. And in their conversation then, Jesus leads the woman beyond the material thing of water for the body to the water that is going to last forever, namely his spirit, his love, his truth. And the woman does finally recognize this. She's open to this. She has an open mind. And she sees that, as she says, you've got to be a big prophet. Now, I think this gospel might suggest a number of different things, of course, but I would like to suggest four touch points for our own lives. Number one, what is our most basic need? What is my most basic need as I see it? Water for my body and all that goes with that, or the Spirit of our Lord Jesus Christ and what that means forever? Number two, can Jesus meet this need that I have? Beginning with the water of baptism. Number three, our encounter with Christ, with Jesus, is not so much at a well of water, although the baptism water is back there, but our encounter with Jesus is most intense when we bring our lives into his life and he brings his life into our life right here in this church. This church is our well where we can meet Jesus in such a beautiful way. And fourthly, the result of this meeting is that human barriers need to be removed. Woman, Samaritan, a Jew. So to go back then again to our basic need. Yes, we need material things. We need to have a bank account, hopefully. We need to take care of these physical bodies. We have our emotional life, our passions. And again, as much as we need all of this, do they become number one? Or what is the, do we see the most basic need we have to satisfy is the need for God's Spirit, his love? Again, as I've mentioned before, you know, what is it that I take with me after I die? Not all the other stuff above. That's what lasts. And as long as we're here, we need the other stuff. But remember what lasts. And then secondly, do I see Jesus as truly having the answer to my life? Is he really my living water? Do I try to understand who he is in this wonderful big church, ever so human church, that he gives us? A church that leads us to take his word, to take his presence, and make it come alive in the time in which I'm living, in 2017, in the world that I live in, the big world and the little world, my family and my school and whatever. And thirdly, have I brought Jesus and my life together? Am I ready to bring Jesus and my life together in this Mass that we're celebrating today? The church is not a filling station. We drive away and that's it. We come here to have our lives changed in some degree, in some way, that what I hear in the message of Jesus is going to have an effect upon the way I live my life with my parents, with my children, with my spouse, with my brothers and sisters, with my classmates, with my workmates, with the people on my street, you name it. Connections got to be made. And in light, therefore, number four of the above, what human barriers am I willing to take down as Jesus did at that well? What prejudgments, prejudices am I ready to let go? What unresolved and unforgiven hurts? What apathy, you know, the couch potato syndrome. I don't care. Just turn on the TV and gawk. Am I willing to let that go when I come here to meet Jesus? And then when I look in the mirror, as I do so often, am I ready to say, or am I ready to say, God loves you ever so much. So very, very much. How much, again, do we as individuals in our world need fresh, clean, sparkling water to survive on this planet Earth? How much more, then, do we as individuals and the world need the water of Jesus Christ? To truly live, not just survive, but to truly live on this planet Earth, limited as it may be now and in the forever, without any limitation that awaits us all in God's eternity. God bless you. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, for through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now as we journey through Lent, may we, like Christ, be willing to enter into deep prayer with our God and bring before him our needs and our hopes.
Our response will be, "Blessed Savior, hear us." For Christians throughout the world, as we continue our Lenten disciplines of prayer, fasting, and sharing, may we experience anew God's faithfulness and come to share in the promise of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed Savior, hear us.
For all those preparing to be baptized this Easter, may they have a deeper awareness of God's loving and life-transforming presence in their lives and the glory that awaits them in the life to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed Savior, hear us.
For all those who suffer from chronic, painful illness, may they experience the healing consolation of Christ through our prayers and loving actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed Savior, hear us.
For those in our parish community who have strayed from God's covenant or rejected his promise of life eternal, may they, in this Lenten season, come to know once more the steadfast love and mercy of God through sharing in the mystery of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed Savior, hear us.
For police officers, first responders, and all who put themselves in harm's way, may God keep them safe as they carry out their duties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed Savior, hear us.
For our faithful departed, including Joseph and Josephine Nalivanko, may they rest in the peace of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed Savior, hear us. Almighty and ever-loving God, hear our prayers and continue to transform our hearts so that we may serve you more faithfully and more fully. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Redeemer, my Savior art thou, if ever
Now let us pray, my brothers and my sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our sins may take care to forgive our neighbor, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And
let us all give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For when he asked the Samaritan woman for water to drink, he had already created the gift of faith within her, and so ardently did he thirst for her faith that he kindled in her the fire of divine love. And so we too give you thanks, and with the angels praise your mighty deeds as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out upon them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and your daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest of love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross, but before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become that lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. And as he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed upon the cross, he took the chalice filled with wine. And once more giving you thanks, he handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Until you come. And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and his resurrection from the dead. And looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, upon those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until that hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. And then freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
Having hopefully in our hearts and minds been formed by the very word of our God, and here today together as the family of the Father, may we now pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be free always from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but rather on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with each and every one of you always. Now may we offer to each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin and the death of our world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished while still here upon this earth with this bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration of God's presence in word and in sacrament is now ended. Let us go then to continue to live our faith in our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Please join us singing our closing hymn, number 346, Be Not Afraid, number 346.
Desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far.